Good morning, children. Welcome to today's EVS class. Children, in the last week, we have started this lesson, Plants Around Us, the fourth lesson, that is Plants Around Us. Okay? And what did we learn? We learned the parts of a plant. Now, let us read this lesson, okay? In class 1, we learned that plants are living things which need water, air, and sunlight to grow. So children, as we have already learnt in standard first, that plants are living things. As I told you, plants are living things, okay? They also need water, air, and sunlight to grow, okay? There are different types of plants growing in different places. So as I told you, all the plants are not the same type. They are growing in different places, and they are different type also. One is small, one is big. So okay, one is grown in particular area, okay, one is grown in some other area. So like this, they are growing in different places also, and they are different types of plants also. So as now here we are going to see about parts of a plant, okay? So children, do you remember in the last class we saw a plant, okay? And what were the parts of that plant? So as I told you, our body functions with the help of external organ, internal organs, okay? So the same way, the plant also has parts of the plant. There are parts in the plant, okay? So first one is the root. So what first part is? Root, stem, leaves, flowers, fruits, okay? So these are the parts of a plant. Plants are fixed to the ground. So what I told you, the roots, what is the main function of the root? It holds the soil tightly and it makes the plant stand straight. So plants are fixed to the ground. Yes, because of that, plants are fixed to the ground and they don't fall off. So we can see some parts of the plant that grow above the ground. So as I told you, the roots, they grow below the ground. You can't see them. The stem, leaf, branches, flowers, fruits, they grow above the ground and they are seen. Yes, we cannot see those parts which grow under the ground. So we cannot see the roots. Why? Because they grow under the ground. Roots grow under the ground. They hold the plant to the ground. So as I told you, they hold the soil tightly and with that they hold the plant to the ground. They absorb water and other nutrients from the soil. So what is the function of the root? They absorb the water and the other nutrients from the soil. Water travels through the stem and the branches to the leaves. So from the ground, the roots, they absorb the water and other nutrients and this they pass to the stem. The stem takes forward the water and nutrients to the branches, leaves. The leaf, with the help of this water and nutrients and the sunlight, it prepares the food. Okay, so the leaf is called as the kitchen of the plant. Okay, leaves are mostly green in color. So leaves are green in color. They make food for the plant using water and sunlight. Flowers are colorful and give out a sweet scent. So children, you might have already smelled the flower and all. You always see a flower and you take it and smell it. You can get the sweet scent. Yeah, you will smell that sweet scent. Okay, they produce fruits and seeds. The flowers, they produce fruits and seeds. Fruits are the fleshy part of the plant. Some fruits have seeds inside them. So as I told you, mango. Okay, so the mango, the tree gets the flower. The flower converts into a fruit, and then the fruit contains a seed inside. It will be having a seed inside them. So these seeds grow into new plants. So the same, if after eating the mango, when the mango is ripe, it is yellow color. After you eat the mango, you can take that seed and put it into the ground and you will get a new plant. Okay. So these seeds grow into new plants if they receive the right amount of water, air, water and sunlight. So when you put it into the ground, you should give the right amount of air, like it should be having little between this, and water and sunlight should be properly given, and then it grows into a new plant.